My name is Dante Gagne, and I'm one of the program managers here on Visual Studio. And today I'm here to share some tips and tricks with you to get more productivity in the editor space in Visual Studio 2022. So let's dive into it. So for starters, one of the first things that we're using in Visual Studio 2022 is a new font. Now, it looks kind of similar to the old one, but you'll notice a few changes. The big thing that we used here is this is the Cascadia font, which was originally developed by the Windows Terminal team to have a little bit more readability, particularly with folks in the accessibility space, folks who have a reading disability, dyslexia, character dysmorphia, and things along those lines. What the font does is add a little bit more weight in the areas that our eyes use to disambiguate one character from the other. We found that's created more productivity in the Visual Studio space by using this font. One of the other things that this font does is introduce the idea of ligatures. Now, these are not new to Visual Studio, but this is the first time Visual Studio has shipped with a font that supports them. If you look down here on line 27, you'll see a handful of character sequences that mean different things in different languages, but they're pretty common. Now, I'm going to press Control Q to bring up Visual Studio Search and search for the font. And I'm going to change the font from Cascadia Mono to Cascadia Code. The only difference between these two fonts is the fact that Cascadia Code has got the ligatures. Now, as soon as I do that on line 27, you'll see that those sequences of characters have been replaced with a single glyph that represents the concept. For instance, the exclamation point equal that means not equal to in C sharp has been replaced with the glyph that mathematically means not equal to. One of the real values of this is for folks with cognitive differences, like folks who show up on the autistic spectrum. This allows them to recognize the concept without having to cognitively recognize a sequence of characters that have a specific meaning. Now, personally, I use the Cascadia Code because I like the glyphs, but this is an example of where you can decide which way you would like to do it. Do you want to use the glyphs or do you want the individual characters? The control of that is left up to you. Another feature that we added originally for accessibility reasons, but we're finding more and more people like it, is the line spacing. The Office Cognitive Reader allows you to increase the amount of spaces between lines, which helps folks who have reading disabilities be able to read the lines more easily. We decided to bring that feature over to Visual Studio. So I'm going to hit Control Q again, search for line spacing, and it'll take me into Tools Options, and I can see the dropdown right here that shows that currently I'm using 1.0, which is no space between lines. Now, if I click on that one and change it to 2.0, as soon as I hit OK, well, this is a preview build of Visual Studio, and it's got a bug in it. But if I move over to this other document, you'll see that it's now spacing those lines out with enough space between them to reduce the character crowding that can be problematic for folks, again, with reading disabilities or folks on the autistic spectrum, where too much character crowding can actually cause problems for them. Another feature that we introduced with Visual Studio 2022 is subword navigation. Now, if I hold down the Control key and press the left and right arrow keys, you'll notice that the cursor moves by entire words at a time. Punctuation is treated as a single word, so here it's components, authorization, and so on. If I also hold down Alt when I hit left and right, you'll notice that now the cursor will go to subwords or camel case navigation. That is, it looks for any capital letters in a word and uses those as a stop as well to allow you to find a particular place in the word that you're looking for. This has been a very highly requested feature for Visual Studio for a long time, and we actually got this from an intern project last summer that we're now able to share with folks, that we're now able to share with all of the Visual Studio folks from here. Selection by word also works. So if I hit Control Shift and move, it will expand the expansion. It will expand the selection by entire words. But if I hold down Control Shift and Alt together, it will now expand or retract the selection by subwords. But we've recently made a few tweaks to it, and I'd like to show those features off. Maybe folks aren't familiar with the original feature, but I definitely want to show off how they've changed. And that's box selection and multiple carats. So I'm going to move my cursor up here, and drop my carat at the beginning of this line. And I'm going to press Shift and Alt as I move out. Now, so long as I stay on the same line, you won't see any changes. But as soon as I hit the up and down arrow keys, you'll see that Visual Studio is creating what we call a box selection. This is a set of cursors in a rectangular selection pattern, and I can type something new. And you'll see that each one of those instances takes the selection, and I can apply repeated edits in multiple locations all at the same time. Box selection has been around in Visual Studio for quite a while. The big tweak that we changed is now how box selection will behave in response to further character navigation. Specifically, if I press the End key, you'll see that the box selection has been broken and each one of the cursors is now its own instance. So now I can press the left and right arrow keys and each one of those cursors will move together, even though I've now been broken of that box selection restriction where everything had to be in a perfect rectangle. You'll even notice at the bottom right here, it shows that I'm now in multi-carat mode, which allows for a little bit easier navigation. And I can do things like up and down arrow, home and end, and everything like that. We'll use the multi-carat behavior. Now, for those who aren't familiar with multi-carat, this allows me to use multiple carats at the same time to do edits in areas that may not be perfectly lined up. So I'm going to press the Control key. I'm going to move my cursor up here by clicking, and then I'm going to press Control Alt and click to create new cursors before each one of the fives. Now I've got multiple cursors that will all react with my cursor keys together. So it's very easy for me to just move over, delete, add one, and now all of those instances have been modified to the specific version that I want. Now, yeah, I could be using Find and Replace to do that, but there are cases where the multi-cursor can be particularly handy, especially if what you want to replace is in the proximity of a token, but not that specific token itself. Now, naturally, we wouldn't want to implement something here that keyboard users wouldn't be able to do. So I'm going to press Escape to abort the multi-carat experience, move myself over to the five and select it, and then I'm going to press Shift Alt period, and that will create an additional carat at the next instance of whatever I had selected. So by hitting Shift Alt and hitting Shift Alt period multiple times, it's created a handful of cursors here, and now I've got that multi-edit experience again. Last but not least, if I wanted to, I could select that five. I'm going to press Escape to abort the mode. I'm going to select the five and hit Shift Alt semicolon, and that will go through and find all of the instances of that string in the particular document that I've got and go ahead and create this carats for me. A quick warning about that last one, though, is the carats that get created may not always be in your viewport. So you can see up here where I had a five, that was changed even though that wasn't something that I could see. Just make sure you know what you're doing with the multi-carat, but it can be extremely powerful when you use it correctly. Undo to fix that so that my document will load correctly next time. Now there's one more command that I want to show that's a little bit more of a safety net than a command. I'm going to press Control-Shift-F to bring up Find in Files. Now, a lot of folks are familiar with this dialog, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to search for a space. Now, normally this isn't an operation that I would do, and over the course of my solution, I've got a lot of instances of spaces throughout all my projects. This is something that if I were to hit find all right now, my CPU would spike, I might experience some UI lags inside Visual Studio. Certainly not what I actually want. Depending on the size of my solution, this could actually cost me a substantial amount of time. Now, the safety net that's in place, if we detect that we found more than 10,000 instances of your match, we're going to bring up a dialogue and warn you, hey, are you sure you actually wanted to kick this off? We found from talking to folks that usually the match they're looking for is in the first couple dozen or even 100 results. So in most cases, if you have a search that has this many results, it probably isn't something you actually wanted. This gives you an opportunity to abort that search and not have to wait for Visual Studio to finish that entire process. Or if it was a search you actually wanted, you can just click Show All and it will go ahead and bring all the results in. Now, if you're the kind of person who frequently does searches where you want more than 10,000 results, there's a checkbox over here to say, you know what, always show it. I don't want you to stop in the way for me. Now, in this case, I don't really care about how many spaces there are in my document, so I'm going to cancel the search. You'll find down at the bottom, it's letting me know that it canceled the search. And over in the status bar, it's giving me a little bit of guidance that, you know, maybe you want to refine your search and try again. These are just a couple of the features that we've added with Visual Studio recently that folks are telling us they're finding a lot of use out of and we wanted to share with you today. So these are just a few of the tips that we're bringing in Visual Studio 2022 to help you be more productive in the editor. Of course, this isn't all of them. We encourage you to take a look at the Visual Studio blog and other sources like that as we get more features that we want to raise the visibility on. As always, thanks a lot for your help and have fun coding.